So how, last time I spoke to you, I remember it was at San Diego Comic Con. You were telling me like you were doing.
That's
like,
right. We were talking about the SpongeBob movie. And
that's
all
right.
That. I remember.
And you have like a half a dozen voices. But how great is it that you're here for Bullwinkle?
You know, you never know where you're going to wind up. You know, that's the great thing about this weird job that I do, is you never know where it's going to take you. You know, I was a kid that grew up, loving Bullwinkle. It was one of my favorite shows as a kid. And, you know, it's one of those shows that I always try to mention in interviews, you know, just to kind of keep the legacy of it alive and maybe direct younger people who haven't seen it yet into the direction of that, checking out that show. And here we go. You know, I auditioned a bunch of times against a lot of other really super talented actors that were also auditioning for the voice match. And for whatever reason of theirs, they wound up picking me. So now it's just up to me to honor the Bullwinkle legacy and the legacy of Bill Scott, the original voice of Bullwinkle, and do my best. My heart's in the right place.
Now, speaking of Bill Scott, I mean, what are the challenges trying to duplicate his voice?
Well, it's kind of a thankless task being a voice match guy. I'd be the first to admit it's not really my forte, but when you inherit a really beloved character, voiced by a really beloved, impeccable voice actor, it's hard to improve on that. And it's also, nobody sounds 100% like someone else. So, whether it's Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck, Fred Flintstone, anybody, that character is going to sound a little different in his second generation incarnation than when the original guy did it. So, there's always going to be complainers out there complaining that that you're not the other guy and you can never be the other guy. So you just do your best and you try to try to hit the ball as much as you can and honor that character. And for me, Bullwinkle is such a iconic part of my my upbringing. Like, who I am up here has so much to do with Jay Ward. Probably Jay Ward and Mad Magazine have more to do with, my mindset and way of looking at the world than pretty much anything.
And, I'm going to make you choose. You have done so many animation characters. What is really your favorite?
Oh, man, you got to love SpongeBob. But I like the Ice King because of his darker, weirder, creepier aspects.
But in terms of legacy characters that you inhabit, Dumbo, I gotta go with the booze.
Okay, terrific. Hey, thank you very much. Thank you.